In this video, we are going to see about file handling in PHP. Already we have, you should have studied handling of files in C and C++. Oh, we are going to see how the PHP handles reading of files. Maybe most probably it's a text file or maybe a binary file. So how it is going to handle those files, getting information from the files. That's what we are going to see. So basically, there are majorly two things. One is opening a file and then reading the file and then writing the file and then closing the file. These are the four steps you have to follow. So first we will see the syntax of opening a file. So we have, it's called file handle. That is, this is nothing but a pointer. We are assigning a pointer for the, in the left hand side, you assign a pointer for the file. Then in the right hand side, this is the keyword fopen, then followed by within the open bracket file name. That is the name, the file which you want to do processing. Then the mode. Mode is nothing but reading or writing mode or appending mode, all those things. Then use include path, and these two are optional. But file name and mode are compulsory. So now we'll see what are they. These are all the mode which you have to give it here. So read. R means read only mode, and the file pointer will be at the starting of the file. And R plus, it is when you give R plus, it will be open for both read and write, and again the file pointer will be at the starting of the file. W, this will be in only write only mode. This is not a read only mode, only write only mode. Since the file pointer is again kept in the starting of the pointer, starting of the file, whatever you write, it will be overwritten. If the file is already existing, if you are going to enter new data, that will be overwritten. It will not append. Okay. So since the file pointer is made to point to the starting. So W plus, it is meant for both reading and writing. Again, the file pointer will be at the start. So whatever you write, if the file is already there and some information is there, when you open it with the W plus or W mode, it will be overwritten. Okay. You will lose the previous content. Suppose I don't want to lose that. I want to append. After, say for example, I have some data in my existing file, I want to add more data to it, mean then you have to better go for A and A plus mode. When A, it is append mode with the file pointer at the end of the file. If the file does not exist, this will create. Here also, W and W plus also, it will not give any error. If the file is not existing, it will create the file and do. Whereas in R and R plus, it must be there. The file must be already there for you to open and read. If it is not there, it will post you the error. So here X and X plus, it is also for create and open, for writing only, similar to our W. But if the file is already exists, it will give you error. So always X will create a new file and then it will add. Same way X plus also. So this is for both reading and writing. If the file already exists, this will give you an error message. X and X plus, W and W plus, X and X plus expects that the file should not be already there. It will create a file. Whereas W and W plus, if the file is already there, it will overwrite. If it is not there, it will create a new file and then write. So these two will not give you error even if the file does not exist. But this will give you error if the file is already existing. This will create a new file and write it. So in all these cases, W, W plus, X, X plus, you will lose the data if you have already the data is there. Whereas better to go for, if you want to append, then you go for A and A plus. Okay. Now we'll see how you can open a file for reading, the first operation. So all these are HTML files, HTML tags, and then this is here we start the PHP, and here we assign the handle. Handle is, it is a user defined name only, but this is a pointer. When you make it as any variable to be the left hand side, and in right hand side you give fopen, this will become the pointer for this file. So now you are giving the file name data.txt. So already this file must be existing. You should have created this file, or else it will post you an error. So then we are opening it in a read mode. And then if handle, this will check whether this file is file, if the file is assigned to that, it is valid or not. Okay, that is if the file is already there and this is assigned to that. If it is true, then file open. It will open the file and it will say the file is open. Yes. Or else it will give you error that file does not exist. Now we'll see this example. See, it is already there, so it gives file open. Okay. Now I just run this file. Run. Is file reading the file. Now this is a data same content. So now we'll see I have created a text file which is called data. Okay, we'll see this is the content of that, and this is what we are going to read in this thing. But here only it is opening, so this this will verify only whether this coding will verify only the handle is allocated and it is meant, it is open for reading. So now I'll exude this. See, opening a file in PHP using fopen. Is file open? Okay. Since it is already there, it give me the, it doesn't give me any error. Now I just open it. Reading file one. And I say, see, since it is already there, it gives me no problem. That is, it has opened. It verifies this and the handle is allocated and it says it's open. Now we'll see this file is not in my folder. Care has to be taken that wherever in which you have to store it, this data1.txt or data.txt in your working folder, or else you have to give the correct path. If you are storing it in some other folder, you have to give the full path here. Since I'm storing it in the same folder where I am executing this PHP, I directly gave this file name. See here, file failed to open stream because no such file or directory is existing. So it gives me the error. Okay, now we are going to see the next program where we are going to how to read. Now we have opened it for reading. Now how to read the line by line information. So for that we have different statements. For example, f gets, get c is for character by character. You can read it by character by character. Each character you can read. And getters is used for us reading a string of text. And if you have, if you want to read the whole content, then you have file get contents. There are so many commands in PHP. Now what we are going to do is we will see if getters how it works. See if handle as usual, you open the file for reading and then you have to give them you have to use it in a loop, so that because there are there may be so many lines, we are going to read one by one line, so in which case you have to put it in a loop, and then each time you have to check whether the handle has, because the file handle will move each and every line. So what you have to do is you have to check whether it has reached the end of the file. So till it reached the end of the file, you have to keep reading and then you have to print it on the screen. That's what our aim. So here what we are doing is file handle. First we assign the file handle to this text file. Then we are opening a while loop where not fuf till it reaches. So while not fuf handle means till it reaches the end of the file, till it becomes true. So it keeps doing the working in the while loop. So $x equal to fgetters. So each line it will be receiving and then printing it on the screen. So this is how it works. Now we'll see how it works. I just open that file already. File two. So this is the file. Just now I have shown you. While not fuf handle, read by string, string of text. And then you post it on the screen. Now we'll see. See, now it has come. Now I just, and I will see how it behaves for this. Yes. So till the end of the line, it will read those things also. Now We are going to see the next one, closing a file. What is closing a file? You just give the fclose. The keyword is fclose and then give the file handle. With this, the file will be closed. So if you want to do further operation, again, you have to open it and then do it. So this frees up the resources connected with the file. So reading from a file.